All right, if you put on the spot, top 10 things in Broken Hill now.
Whew, okay. The walking tour of Broken Hill, definitely that's another one. The Pro Heart Museum, Pro Heart Art Gallery, very cool. The Line of Load and the Miners Museum is excellent.
Goes in the air, they're inhaling it and they're cutting their lungs out. And so what they'll do, they'll smoke an opium in here to kill the pain so they can go to work. It was a vicious cycle. Once they set the New South Wales Health Commission up here, not as big as that, of course. Up on top of his head frame, of his little, where his winch was, and he'd make it out of galvanised iron or whatever. If there's any wind like today, it would spin around and force the air down the bottom. And a lot of houses here in Broken Hill, you notice they've got these windlasses on top. They're little round things that spin around. A lot of the houses in Sydney, you've got to tell you what they do, they cool the ceiling down. The hot air that's in there between your roof and your ceiling, that cools that down. That's what they are, windows.
Simply unbelievable. So at the moment we're walking into the Broken Hill Workers Memorial. Each of these plaques, all these millions, oh not millions, I don't know how many, 900 plaques represent miners that have all passed away in the construction of the mining of the ore. It's an unbelievably nice structure. Great memorial to the guys that gave their life.
The Living Desert sculptures.
Four.
The Living Desert conservation and there's a Living Desert walk that you can do.
Five. There must be a sensible time of the day to do this. We've started off early Friday. Motives are on the pole. You have a better understanding of the culture. Like this chap here, his head's pointed up, this one down, and the next head is covered in beads. We turn around. This is obvious, this is the snake. And this one here.
Caves, such as this one, are important aids to survival. They provide shelter from the hot sun and dry north winds in summer, and give warmth and protection from the cold winds and rain in winter. Caves were used by Aboriginal people as well as by birds, mammals, reptiles, and insects. Wasps have built mud nests along the roof and walls of the cave. The Uro or Wallaroo can camp in such caves some distance from drinking water as it obtains much of its moisture requirements from dew and from the vegetation on which it browses. It also conserves its body moisture by sheltering from the sun in caves under rock ledges and in gullies and dense undergrowth.
So doing it hard, but the thing that I've discovered is if you find a tree like this that provides a bit of shade, your body temperature drops within 30 seconds. It's just quite amazing. Out there at the moment, what would the temperature be, you reckon? 30-something, 33, 34. Under here, with the wind blowing past, in the shade, you feel like it's dropped down about 25.
Silverton. Oh yeah, Silverton. So
one, we'll say that's six. Outback Camels.
Silverton, seven. Outback Camels. The
John's Gallery.
John Dynan's Art Gallery. Oh gosh, two more things. We've done so many more things than that.
Picture.
Broken Hill, it was awesome. And
Hindsight last night.
Yeah, Junction Mine.
10 best things to do in Broken Hill. Would you come back to Broken Hill?
Yes.
Would you recommend Broken Hill to anybody else?
Yes, excellent.
How long would you suggest to stay?
At least 5 or 6 days, I think, to fit everything in and not feel rushed.
Would you recommend the train trip?
Yes, I think that was quite, it was quite good actually. We're going home tomorrow, so we'll, try it out again.
And the really cool thing is, the people in Broken Hill are just beautiful. They're all super friendly. Anything else?
Salt of the earth people. No, that's good.
So if you like this video,
give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button.
We'll see you in the next one. Broken Hill, sensational.